Alrighty everybody, welcome back to another washer video. And today right here is that we're going to do a load of towels, which is not much of it, which is I believe we got, is the 5 towels, which is not much of it. Only we got 3 towels and 2 cloths. Who's been on the floor every time, so I thought I might be curious if I can wash that during the video. So, right here, I have 2 bath towels right now, which is, you see there's purple one, pink, and original beach towel. Don't ask why if I'm using this one, because I have to use one for drying my hair a little more after if I come out of the shower. But I just want to make sure I want to get it around my back and then get my hair on top of it. That way it should continue dripping before it's drying. But I really want to make sure my hair is dry, so that way I don't want it to make drippy everywhere on my stuff in my room, including on the floors and everything. And the reason you're curious, why is there 5 in here? Good question. Only 2 cloths. So only 3 towels and 2 cloths in the washer right now. If there's more something, I should go ahead and wash. Actually, I should wash that one since it's been on the floor. Trying to touch the, the
pink fluff thing from
the behind the wall. Don't try to touch that, because, yeah. Hey, JoJo. So, yeah. By the way, during the 10th one, I have to clean this right here. Since there's the, sand right here, the dirty gunk of sand, and the dirty leftover gunk of softener. So I think about it. I need to decide to wipe it off to make sure I don't want to make a mess anymore. I just want to make sure it's clean conditioned, just like delivery since back in December 10th, 2020. And trash can updates for you all before getting a new one. Let me show you. So yeah, during the attempt one, I decided to give up by using the, trash can lid. So here it is. This is where the lid is right now, and this is where the holder can be, which is a latch, and then when you push it down it opens. So I decided to finally just pull it off and snapped it, and now it's in the trash right now. Looking forward to go get some new trash can, so that way I don't want to think of doing something with the issues anymore. So, coming up soon. Alright, anyways. Today, the detergent we're going to use today is this. Which is, of course, the detergent sheet, which is the Earth Breeze, which is the Eco Sheets. And there's more coming out already. Just dead. No softener at this time, because I remember my family never uses towels with a softener right now, just like other people can do. So I thought we might be precaution for the softeners or something else. So it's just like when we did it as the previous machine with no softener. Well, no, not the agitator cap. We do have a fabric softener dispenser, which is, of course, the Centennial MVW C6ESWW. So, yeah, we do, I mean, so since story, of course, on a Centennial machine, they do have a fabric softener selector. So, let me tell you about this before starting up this machine. So, during the finale rinse, of course, when no softener is selected, it should do its light rinse water. And when softener is added, of course, uses for the, of course, the deep water rinse during the rinse cycle. Oh yeah, as you're wondering around my trash, around my tripod, why is it standing a little taller? That's a good question. I'm using my clothes basket right now to make sure I don't want to cause an issue for letting the tripod falling off for opening the stupid lid. tripod is already set. So let me back up the door so that way I should close it. So, alright. So this one's already adjusted. So this is not going to be much load, so I should go ahead and get started to make sure. Put it on to normal, of course. Tall cycle's already up. Wow, already. Okay, enjoy. Hopefully the audio will pick it up. Just before that, viewers, let me pause that for a second. I found something on the floor, which is in the kitchen, in the small kitchen area. Let me, yeah. Yeah, look at that, how nasty this is. Yeah. Let me put this in here a little quick. Darn it, I need to move my tripod. Here we go. Load it in here. Here we go. Let's continue this cycle, shall we? A little bit difficult for a setup. Try again. Okay. Enjoy, viewers. Hopefully no interruption right now.
Thank you.
Okay, that's the second video of the sounding of the Maytag washing machine right here. And, I would say the first spin might be going to be, the first spin might be terrible because it didn't distribute. Maybe it's just too long for distributing. So, yeah, it just decided to advance to the rinse cycle because due to the light for the wash, it has a little bit of trouble distributing right here, which I can barely hear all the way downstairs. Upstairs in my room, of course, I can hear water valve running, anything else. I can hear the basket drive a little bit. Excuse my cough because I have a little bit of cold right now. Alright. Again, that's the cycle video of the sounding of the towel cycle on the Maytag washer MHW5630HW. The supplies around here. Just a small one, actually. Gee. So yeah, here's the trash can that I showed you earlier. The broken latch. Looking forward to go get a new one right now. Drippy gasket around here. Let's see. Seems very dry, which is good. Well, you know, it's not very, very clean, but it still has marks. I don't know if this detergent might 100% work. Yeah, this is not actually 100% clean. It's just actually stained. You know, I know this cloth might be, it's supposed to be a towel. I mean, think about regular and normal, it might be the colors. But we don't actually have the color cycle on this brand model because due to the model right here. Did a really good job right here. Alright, that's the video of the Maytag doing the towel cycle, which is the sounding of it. Alright, hopefully I'll catch you in another video. Thanks for watching.